Welcome back, and to the last video that looks at defining a talented athlete and what makes them talented. So far we have looked at the definitions of talent, the biological characteristics of talent, the psychological characteristics of talent, and how talent is identified. In this last video we are going to look at talented athletes and how they have transferred their skills to different sports. Helen Glover is an example of an athlete that has transferred skills from one sport to another and has been successful. 4 years previous to her gold medal in the rowing at the 2012 Olympics in London, she was an aspiring hockey player. Growing up, she'd been a keen cross-country runner and she'd been consistent at playing hockey at a high level. It wasn't until 2008 that she heard about the Sporting Giants scheme. This scheme was to find successful Olympians for the future. She undertook this scheme in 2008 and onwards, the rest is history. Was it because of her endurance and stamina levels from cross country and strength of forearms from hockey a reason to her success in rowing? Another athlete with a similar backstory is Adam Jamieli. He was formerly a football player, defender for Football League 2 side Dagenham and Redbridge. Previous to this, he was a youth player at Chelsea. In 2012, Adam Jamieli focused on athletics full time instead of pursuing his career in football. In 2012, he won gold at the 100 metres World Junior Athletics in Barcelona. In 2014, he then won silver at the Commonwealth Games. And 2 weeks later from that, he won the 200 metres at the European Athletic Championships. Was a factor of his success because of the high intensity demands football requires during matches and training? These are two great examples of athletes from athletics that have taken their skills from one sport and transfer them over to another sport to become successful. Examples of where skills can be present in multiple sports are the following. A smash in badminton can be similar to an overhead smash in tennis. A goal kick in football can be very similar to a conversion kick in rugby. The strength in gymnastics can cross over to the strength in weightlifting. And the quick feet in boxing can be shown by quick feet in fencing. From this idea, it may make more sense to develop a comprehensive and well-integrated talent development system which would facilitate the transfer between sports of athletes who have already received investment from sport. These systems could then be supported by the educated coaches who have experience and understanding of the challenges faced by talent transfer athletes. This is from Collins et al. In 2014. The UK talent team from UK Sport have worked in partnership with recruitment campaigns to find successful athletes. Examples are Sporting Giants 2007, Pitch to Podium 2008, Girls for Gold in 2008, Tall and Talented in 2009, Fighting Chance in 2009, and many more campaigns. We are going to focus on the Sporting Giants campaign in 2007. This is the campaign that Helen Glover came through in order to be a successful rower. Sir Steve Redgrave issued a rallying call to tall athletes with the potential to become Olympic heroes of the future, launching the first UK sport talent ID campaign, this being Sporting Giants in 2007. The search got underway. 58 athletes were selected onto Olympic development programmes from this campaign. This included handball, rowing, volleyball, canoeing. 17 competed internationally. From this, 3 World Championship medals were won, 5 Senior World Cup medals were won, and 1 Under-23 World Cup medal. World Cup Championship was won. The second campaign that I'd like to focus your attention towards is the Pitch to Podium campaign. This is run by the UK Sport and English Institute of Sport. They offer released apprentices and first year professional players the chance to take up a new challenge and switch talent to targeted Olympic sports. The Pitch to Podium campaign provides young people, roughly 18 to 22 year olds, who have not yet secured professional football contracts and take an alternative route in Olympics. In total, UK Sport and English Institute invited over 1,000 young academy players released from football clubs to attend Olympic talent assessment events. If these players are successful at talent assessment events, they will go on to more specific assessments. This campaign is really beneficial as skills from talented athletes don't go to waste. It also stops players from falling from grace and having potential difficulties in life. This is such as job issues, mixing with the wrong crowd, and maybe crime problems. And it also gives players a plan B in life. Should we therefore recycle sports more often? There are many post-puberty athletes who do not achieve expertise or who leave their sport due to age, injury or deselection, but still possess physiological capacities and skills that can be used in other sporting disciplines. This is from Goulburn in 2008. Thank you for listening to the series of What is Talent? I hope you now have a better understanding of how talented athletes are made. My last point that I'll leave you with is, remember, talent can come in lots of different shapes and forms.